any hockey fan would have loved what you said. I don't care where I play. I don't care what role I play. At the end of the day, our ultimate goal is to win a Stanley Cup, to bring that to the city of Toronto. That professionalism that you showed, where did that come from?
I mean, it's just something I think you get accustomed to. I mean, at this point, we've had a lot of history and losing hockey games in Toronto in previous years. Now I'm just at the point where I just want to win. So I want to be a part of something special.
Naz, you spent a lot of time in Toronto. You referenced maybe some of the more difficult years in the past, but we both know that city very well, and there's always a sense of optimism around the Leafs every year. But does this year almost feel a little bit different to you in your time with the Leafs about what this team could accomplish, both within the organization and also amongst the fans?
Definitely. I mean, there's definitely, the expectation is for sure there. And now I think as we continue and you look at us over the last, 3-4 years, the standard has increased every single year. And so it should. So I think the guys are ready and just kind of anxious to get the season started.
When this news broke, can you remember where you were and what your immediate reaction was?
I was actually out of town, and I was pretty surprised myself. I mean, I had obviously an indication that, Johnny, would have some interest in Toronto, but I didn't really see it happening. And when I heard the news, I was beyond thrilled because obviously me and JT go way back, and he's a great teammate and a good person, and certainly a great hockey player as well.
Naz, your career has taken an interesting path in that you were drafted as an incredibly skilled offensive player, and you are still that, but yet you've kind of developed a defensive, agitating kind of style as well in the NHL. Where did that growth come from, and kind of who helped you along the way to becoming the good defensive player you are now to go along with the excellent offense?
Just teachers and, coaches. I think staff helped me a lot. I've accepted these challenges, and when I was first, brought this opportunity, I kind of wanted to be the best I could. So, as far as the physical game and the agitating, that's something I've kind of always tried to implement in my game. Even throughout my junior career, just try to be as physical as possible. And, because not every single game you're going to get every single bounce that you feel you deserve. And I feel like you got to take a different approach to get yourself into the game. So, that's something I've always done and something I'm happy to continue doing.
You've been very consistent about wanting to make a positive impact in the community. Your foundation, benefiting the Canadian Mental Health Association, is something you feel strongly about. Why is that so important to you?
Very important. I just feel, statistically wise, a lot of young people suffer from mental illness, and I just want them to know that we're here for them and we got their backs. And I feel like it's brave and courageous for them to recognize that there may be an issue, and we're here to help. So with the help of the Nazem Kadri Foundation, kind of tried to tackle this problem and end the stigma.
Really well said, Nazem. Well done, and congratulations for that and your golf tournament that supported all of that. Now, it's been obviously a very busy summer for you. You have the hockey changes, you have the charitable endeavors, and you got some life changes as well. Recently, we're married. What was that like, and the honeymoon, and interrupting your summer of training for a couple special weeks?
It was fun. It was fun. It was a little bit stressful, but now that it's all said and done, I wish I could go back and have that night continue. So, for the honeymoon, we just went to Europe for a little bit, toured Europe, which was a nice little break, kind of divided the off season a little bit. So now we're back into it and getting back on the ice a little more often and gearing up for training camp.
Last thing for you. We saw the picture at the Roman Coliseum. Did you do the thumbs up, thumbs down, gladiator style?
I love that movie. I actually watched it that night.
Yes.
After I went there. So I was, I was pretty entertained myself. And, that's certainly a highlight from my trip.
That's awesome. Thanks for joining us. Congrats on such an exciting summer.
All right. Appreciate it, guys.